Hello, and welcome to another edition of News 6. This week, News 6 is brought to you by the 6th graders of Old Fort Elementary in Old Fort, Ohio. Our first story is about how farm machinery has changed over the years. David Gibson has that story.
Thanks, Amy. Farming has changed a great deal since the settlers tilled the land with a horse and a plow. Farm machinery has become more and more efficient and more expensive. News 6 recently visited the Paul Molliott farm in Old Fort. Mr. Molliott has quite an impressive collection of antique farm machinery. His oldest piece of equipment was manufactured in 1929 and is worth $750 today. News 6 reporter Trenton Hack talked with Mr. Molliott's son, Ed, about his father's collection.
Can you tell us about your antique farm machinery?
My father started collecting antique farm machinery about 9 years ago, and the reason he did this was to keep memories alive of how times have changed over the years and the different changes in farming.
How are the tractors used today different from the old tractors?
The older tractors were used primarily for cultivation, plowing, and they were not real versatile. They were awfully heavy, they compacted the soil, whereas today we have large flotation tires that the tractors roll right over the top of the ground and do not pack the soil like the old antique tractors did. We look at the antique farm machinery, we can see a big difference from steel wheels to rubber tires.
How did you acquire these tractors?
There's different antique farm magazines that are around, and my dad kind of keeps an eye on them to see if he can pick up one of these old tractors, bring it back here and restore it. By that, reconditioned tractor, try and get original parts, paint it up, get the different decals that go with it, and when he gets it down, he'll set it out here with the rest of them.
Thank you, Mr. Molliott, for talking to us about your antique farm machinery. This is Trenton Hack reporting for News 6.
Thanks, Trenton. Old Fort has a very active industrial arts program, which begins in junior high. Under the guidance of the industrial arts teacher, Mr. Dan Fox, 7th and 8th graders learn how to use drafting tools and to design their projects on paper. A display rack is an example of a first project for many beginners. As they make it, they become familiar with the files, saws, sanders, and lathes. They also learn to use safety devices such as goggles. When the students become freshmen, they have learned the basic skills required for working with wood, and they are ready for more challenging projects such as a desk or cedar chest. Once the student begins a major project, he or she may work as quickly or as slowly as necessary. Students soon learn the actual cutting and arranging of the pieces of wood is not the most difficult part, rather it's the careful sanding of each piece of wood and the careful finishing that makes the end product a thing of beauty.
Thanks, Jason. Few people can pass a certain bridge in our community without stopping to admire its rustic beauty. The bridge is an old covered wooden one, the kind we don't see anymore. The new bridge made of concrete and steel has been constructed just a short distance downstream. Although it is safe and much more functional, it can't compare to the simple beauty of the mall-covered bridge. A group of farmers built the mall-covered bridge over Wolf Creek in 1851. It was named after the Wall family. Oak, white pine, and limestone were used to construct the bridge. The cost at the time was about $75. The bridge was built wide enough and tall enough to pull a good-sized load of hay through it. In case of rain, farmers could pull their wagon inside the bridge, close the doors at both ends, and stay dry. The Mall Bridge is the only covered bridge still standing in Ballville Township in Sandusky County, and it is listed in the National Register of Historical Places. It is being preserved and maintained by the Sandusky County Historical Society.
Thanks, Becky. As we end today, we hope you enjoyed our program and will join us next week when News 6 will be presented by Defiance High School, Defiance Middle School, and Defiance High. But before we close, we'd like to take a few minutes to remember a friend.
On Saturday, February 4th, the students in Mrs. Bennett's class lost a classmate and a friend, Jennifer Lynch. Jennifer, her 11-year-old brother Jeff, and her parents died of smoke inhalation when they were trapped in an upstairs bedroom by a fire that started in a television set in their living room. It is always hard to lose a friend, and we are left with many thoughts of Jennifer. We'd like to share some of these with you now. We remember Jennifer as a kind and caring friend, always considerate of her classmates. We remember that her church was a very important part of her life, and that she and her family were active members of the United Methodist Church in Old Fort. We remember that Jennifer loved flowers and the beauty of outdoors. We remember her as a student who loved school, who was friendly to everyone, and who was always willing to participate in school activities. Projects. Jennifer worked hard on a story for News 6 and was looking forward to being a part of this production. We would like to dedicate this News 6 program to Jennifer.